We've talked a lot about analytic functions and how they can be represented by power series. But not every function is analytic. To be fair, lots and lots of functions are analytic, and power series are a really powerful way of describing them. But there are exceptions. So this video is about what can go wrong in the process. But before we talk about what can go wrong, let's see what we want to get right. So for a nice function like e to the x or sine of x, which we've seen are analytic and can be expressed as power series, we take a whole bunch of derivatives at a point a. You know, the most convenient point is a equals 0, but we can do it around some other point as well. We define some coefficients. The kth coefficient is just the kth derivative at a divided by k factorial. And then we hope that the k plus first derivative isn't too big, and if it's not too big, then we know that the remainder term is fairly small, at least when x is pretty close to a. And if the remainder term is small, and if it gets smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller as we take n goes to infinity, well, that means that our Taylor polynomials are getting closer and closer and closer to our function, and that means that our function is the limit of the Taylor polynomials. And that's what an infinite series means. An infinite series means the limit of a finite series. So that's what we want to have go right. So how can all that break down? Well, one way it can break down is if you can't keep taking derivatives. You know, if I look at the function f of x is the absolute value of x cubed, and I want to work around x equals 0, I'll discover that, well, the function makes sense at 0, and the first derivative makes sense, and the second derivative makes sense, but the third derivative does not make sense. The second derivative has a kink at x equals 0, and the third derivative just doesn't work at all. So if you can only differentiate a certain number of times, you can't make a Taylor series out of it. You can do a Taylor polynomial. If you can differentiate k times, you can come up with a kth order polynomial that approximates the function. But you can't have a k plus first order polynomial. And you don't even have a formula for what the error term of that k plus first polynomial is, at least not in general. You can in some specific cases. Okay. There are other functions where you can take the Taylor series, all of the derivatives exist. The 139th derivative, the 3 millionth and fourth derivative, they all exist, but they grow too quickly. So for example, imagine you had a function whose nth derivative at the origin was n factorial squared. Well, that would tell you that the nth coefficient of the Taylor series would be n factorial squared over n factorial, and that's just n factorial. So the Taylor series would become the sum of n factorial times x to the n. But by the ratio test, the radius of convergence of that series is 0. It doesn't, you know, the series just doesn't converge anywhere except right at x equals 0. So the Taylor series doesn't work. Now you might wonder, how could you ever cook up a function that has derivatives that are that bad? In fact, it's a bit complicated. I'm not going to write down the formula for that function, but it does exist. And finally, there's the weirdest way in which a Taylor series can fail, and that is that sometimes you get a Taylor series that converges, but it converges to the wrong answer. So the classic example of that is a function that's 0 for x negative and e to the minus 1 over x for x positive. A graph of that looks kind of like that. It's 0 for x negative, and then it gets bigger. And if you examine the way that it approaches the origin, you discover that f prime, that it is differentiable at x equals 0. You have to take the limit of f of x minus f of 0 divided by x from both sides. And on the left, it's easy. And on the right, you have to take this limit. And you do this limit using L'Hopital's rule, and you do some manipulations, and you discover that the limit is 0. And then if you do the same kind of analysis, you discover that the second derivative is also exists and is also 0. The third derivative exists and is zero. All of these derivatives exist, and so that would give us, and they're all zero, so the Taylor series would be 0 plus 0x plus 0x squared plus 0x cubed and so on. Well, that certainly converges. The radius of convergence is infinite. All the terms are zero. It adds up to zero, but it doesn't add up to e to the minus 1 over x. So if I do the Taylor series, then over here, if I plug in a value of x over here, I get the correct function value, namely 0. But if I plug in a value of x over here, I get the wrong function value. I get 0 when I'm supposed to be getting e to the minus 1 over x. So the bottom line is the common functions that you see formulas for, they tend to all be analytic. But there are functions that aren't, either because they're not differentiable, or because the derivatives are too big, or because something weird happens. They could be smooth, infinitely differentiable, but still not be analytic.